Hi, welcome again to Art Arts. Today we are in Siena, in the Cathedral Museum, the Museum of the Opera del Duomo. I wanted to show you the Nativity of the Virgin Mary by Pietro Lorenzetti. Pietro Lorenzetti was the elder brother of Ambrogio Lorenzetti. You remember the painter of the good and the bad government in Palazzo Pubblico? Here it is. And both of them were painters, with Simone Martini. They were the three most important painters in the beginning of the 1300s, the first half of the 1300s in Siena. We're talking about the bronze, the silver, and the gold medal in this kind of Olympics. To me, Pietro is the gold, but it's just my opinion. They received the most important commissions by the most important institutions of the city, so the Republic itself, the Hospital of Santa Maria della Scala, the cathedral, privates, so the nobles or convents. So a lot of pieces of art are in Siena. Some of them are in the countryside too, in the surroundings of the older Republic territory, and a lot of them are abroad. So yesterday we talked about this shipwreck of the Siena art, and that's it. Ampietro realized this altarpiece by commission of the Office of Maintenance of the Cathedral, the Opera del Duomo, and because they wanted four new altarpieces for the four new altars dedicated to the four patron saints of the city of Siena, just maybe less important than the Virgin Mary, but there were four. And they were, you remember, San Savino, Sant'Anzano, San Crescenzio, e San Vittore. So Ambrogio realized the presentation at the temple to the Virgin Mary, Pietro realized the Nativity of the Virgin Mary, Simone realized the Annunciation of the Virgin Mary herself, and Bartolomeo Burgalini, the last one, realized the Nativity of Christ. These altarpieces, these altars were on the left and on the right of the main one. I'm sorry, here in the center, you can see it well. This is the plan of the church as it is now. It's a bit different from the 1300s one. So in the center, there was the huge altarpiece realized by Duccio some decades before, the Maestà, that is in the Opera del Duomo too, in the same room as the Pietro Lorenzetti's painting. And in these two altars here on the left and on the right were the other four altarpieces. So you have to imagine the church by candlelight, this the gilded huge altarpieces, the colors. I think it was really majestic. Pietro, in his youth, worked in Assisi, like Simone did. After Giotto, worked there in the fresco cycle of the life of the Saint Francis in the Upper Basilica in Assisi. So he perfectly knew the Giotto's painting, and so Giotto's style, and the research for new space, for kind of not scientific perspective, and this kind of space boxes he realized in these paintings. But here in this altarpiece, Pietro went a step forward. I'm showing. This is the piece of art, and you see he's not he didn't realize a space box inside the altarpiece, but he made the altarpiece itself a room, or actually, two rooms. So the big one, the bedroom of Saint Anne, that is just gave birth to the Virgin Mary here, just taking her first bath. And in the corridor, in the hallway, in the waiting room outside, the man and Pietro is showing us Saint Joachim receiving the message of the news. So everything went well. It's a girl, and her name is Mary. So you see, it's a realistic space, because just beyond them, beyond these two men, there's a courtyard with some columns, and beyond again, there's a room, a door, and a room. You can see there are some windows. So it's a realistic space, but it's not real. Pay attention. Just above them, there's a mullioned window, and the sky is not blue, it's gold. It's a sacred space. It's not a real one, but as sacred Secret has been realized as a typical Sienese house, a typical Sienese bedroom, not a Sienese, I mean, like a poor one or a worker one. We are talking about a very wealthy family, so all these girls and women are highly dressed, and all this we have all these embroiders in the fabric that are typical Sienese, this black over the white, and we have this Scottish fabric here on the bed, and there are some discussions about the origin of this kind of fabric, if it's Scotland or it's Siena, probably Scotland, but they are just studying. And so the two columns that divided these three different spaces are the same columns, the same pillars of the altarpiece. So it's a very unusual, very new construction of the space that's been copied a lot of time. It became not only this one, but all the four altarpieces, they became a trend topic in Siena. And so only they couldn't do any of this iconography without looking at these four examples. So I'm showing you some cases. We are here in the 80s of the 1300s in a more Gothic painter, Pietro Giovanni Fei. Qui siamo, here we are in, sorry, in late Gothic, and here we are in pure Renaissance, about a Sienese Renaissance. This painter is another Sienese one, Maestro dell'Osservanza. We are a century later the altarpiece of Pietro, but you see it's still up to date to them, to Siena. So tomorrow, thank you for your attention first, and then tomorrow we will go on the countryside. I'm showing you, that this guy is Saint Bernardo Tolomei and the Abbey of Monteoliveto Maggiore inside the Clay Hills. See you tomorrow.